Hey everybody, it's week three of the Sister Series webinars, and we are just going straight forward to not live recording.
No.
We are just recording this right off the gate because we clearly have issues with technology. So we're keeping it classy, using all of our free software. And
even that we've had problems
yeah,
with.
So we're killing it. Everyone, we should do an e-course on how to do webinar series.
But we thank you for your patience and joining us via, I guess, email. And then maybe in the future we'll figure out live stuff. But for now, you're going to get the next two as recorded webinars. So here we go.
Yes.
Game on. Welcome to week three, right? Already?
Week three, yeah. One more to go after this week. Today we are talking about meal planning, which is like near and dear to my heart. So I'm excited to drop some truth bombs. And
you're such a dork.
And just talk a little bit more about what I'm so passionate about. But first, we'll just do a quick introduction in case this is anyone's first time watching our videos. I'm Melissa. I have two kids. I work full-time in marketing, and my little side hustle is crafting for one. And for two, I have a blog. You can find it at melissaleaserplanning.com, and then you can also follow me on Instagram at melissaleaserplanning. And my name is spelled kind of weird. It's M-A-L-I-S-A.
Thanks, Mom.
L-I-E-S-E-R, planning.com. Or you can find me on Pinterest at pinterest.com/mleaserplanning.
And I'm Molly. I'm her younger sister. I am a business owner. I own my own personal training business here in St. Paul. I have a little guy named Sully, and I'm married to George. So what we like to say is we're kind of, the two of us marry fitness and food together. So I have, my strong suit is definitely the fitness side of a healthy life, and I am really working hard on incorporating whole foods into our family, more than just the typical, I'd say 50% of the time like we used to do, and make it more of like 90 to 100%. And then she is the master meal planner and whole foods guru of our family. So this webinar is just about us trying to teach you how to incorporate them into your everyday life. And then my website, you can find out more about me and my personal training services. I also do virtual training, so I don't just do one-on-one. It's at mollydoylefitness.com. And then I'm also posting all the time on Instagram, and that's Molly D Fitness on Instagram and Facebook. So
yes, you should check out her Instagram on Wednesdays, especially because she does her UFW workouts, which is
unfuckable with workouts of, on Wednesday. So my whole kind of motto for, my business. So I love to swear, work hard and to just be unfuckable with, like, you are the boss of yourself and your body. And bringing that into your workouts, I think, is just a mindset that makes you work harder and makes you want to be stronger and a better you. So, yeah, I post workouts a lot, but on Wednesdays we post the unfuckable with. And so that will be on today. So, yeah, find me. And then we both post stories on our Instagram all the time of us, like, cooking with our kids or our clients doing our workouts or whatever it might be. So, yes, join us.
Yeah.
We're really cool.
Yeah, super.
Something like that.
So meal planning. I think it gets a bad rap for some people because people think it takes too much time. It's too much effort.
Yeah, I feel like we definitely get like eye rolls when we talk about, that our family meal plans or that meal planning is a topic of today. But it's doable and it helps. And we're going to talk about in what areas in your life it's going to help with, which is actually a lot. So.
Yeah, and if you invest the time up front, you're going to save time in the long run. So, yes, you might have to spend a couple of hours on a weekend planning and shopping and prepping, but it's going to save you so much time and stress in the long run that it's really worth it. And I actually like really enjoy my like Saturday or Sunday nap time, meal prep time, because it's just like I get to be in the kitchen without kids hanging on me or yelling for me because they're sleep, you know, they're sleeping during this time, and I can just get a whole bunch of stuff done in an hour and a half and be good for the week.
And that might be you, sis, because not a lot of people would find meal planning as enjoyable, but I've grown to, for sure. I mean, it wasn't something, and we're going to talk a little bit about our households and you know, how we kind of got to where we are with meal planning, but it was not always a fun thing for me. It was actually a chore, and it still kind of can be at times, so I recruit my husband to help with different ideas, or I'm always asking my sister, what are you making this week, or my girlfriend, so I'm getting there, and I'm starting to love it, but I think once you see the benefits of it, it does become a lot more enjoyable, and also kind of going back, like, on last week, it's fun to see how what you can make in a week for as cheap as possible too. Like, I like to find recipes that aren't going to break the bank. So,
yeah. So we've kind of covered it here, but why does meal planning rock? Well, one, it saves you time. It saves you trips to the store. It saves you money. It saves you stress.
It saves you fights with your husband because you're just going to know what's for dinner.
Yeah.
And I had a lot of that in my household. I think it was just, I was kind of a fly by the seat of my pants. Like, I'd go to the grocery store, I'd maybe have two or three meals in mind, and then I'd forget an ingredient. And he'd be like, hey, what's for dinner tonight? Or what should I make tonight? And it's like, oh, this. And then he's like, okay, well, where's this item? And it was just always something until we really got down with, you know, Sundays are our meal planning days, Mondays are our grocery shopping days, and we do that for the whole week. So for me, it really saved a lot with my roommate. I mean, I don't care who that could be for you, a boyfriend, a girlfriend, or, you know, a friend or whatever. But, you know, it saved a lot of stress in that aspect just for George and I, because I just was not good at it unless I wrote it down. And then we're going to the store and then we're adding in things into our cart that we, you know, didn't need. And so, yeah, it's definitely a money saver for those that are on a budget. And I feel like who wouldn't want to just save money when you can. Just buy yourself a new pair of shoes with this money you save on groceries.
Yeah. And so the reason that you're saving money is because when you plan ahead, you are hopefully just going to go to the store the one time. So you're not going to be grabbing those impulse purchases and racking up a $50 bill at Target when you went for two things that would have been $10. And the other way is that when you plan your meals, you can make sure that you're using all of the ingredients that you're going to buy. So if you're planning your meals for the week and you know you're going to have half of a carton of chicken broth left after you make your soup, well, then you should try to plan meals that will use that up so you're not wasting it, or you know, you have to go buy another full carton the next week to get the amount that you would need for another recipe when you could have just used up the half that you have. So
that's, I think, advanced meal planning right there, but it does come with time. Like, thinking about it like that, I think it comes with time, but it might not be quite as easy for a little bit, but then you'll realize, you know, that you can utilize the things you already have and make, you know, two meals out of one or whatever it might be.
Yeah. Or get creative with the stuff you do have left with making lunches or adding stuff to your breakfast. I am putting together a free email course on meal planning. It's going to be a 5-day course for free. All you have to do is register on my website, and that will be coming out, I hope, in February. I'm really working hard on it and building it out right now. So keep an eye out for that. If meal planning is something you're struggling with but want to get better at, I think it will be useful for those people. So why don't we talk about how we do our weekly calendars?
Okay.
Yep. Should I go first?
Yeah.
Okay. So for me, for my family, we either go shopping on Saturday or Sunday every week. And it sucks that it's the weekend because that's when everybody else is shopping. But, you know, we work. So we have, you know, we work normal office jobs. So we have to do it on those days. So what I do is usually as we're wrapping up breakfast, I get my little menu board, which is just, it's a picture frame with a piece of scrapbook paper in it. And then I just write with a dry erase marker on it with the days, and the meals that we're planning. So I get that out. I get my grocery shopping list out, and then I get my phone out so I can be looking at Pinterest and other resources for finding meals. And I plan Sunday through Saturday. So we always start our week on Sunday, and I always take into consideration what we have going on that week.
That's big too.
So if I know we're going to be rushing out of the house for something, or my husband has broom ball at a weird time and he's not going to be there to help with dinner, or, you know, I'm going to be gone like tonight so we can plan an easy meal for my husband to make for the kids. I just get my, you know, I look at my Google Calendar, or I look at our paper calendar we have hanging up, and just try to decide what we have going on that week before I even plan any recipes, because planning for your week and your specific schedule is really how to make meal planning work.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just, you know, I start with Sunday, Monday, which is where I usually make my biggest meals that I know will have leftovers, because we take leftovers for lunch almost every day. So by starting the week having a loaded fridge full of leftovers, we don't have to scramble on Monday morning getting lunch ready, or, you know, having to go out to eat because we didn't plan, which is also another way you'll save money. And then I usually make one other big meal that will have leftovers in the middle of the week. So then Thursday and Friday we have leftovers if we need them. My husband goes out to lunch every Thursday just as a part of his work group. And so I usually pick Thursday too if I'm going to go out to eat, but it varies. We usually go out once each week for lunch. So that's kind of my basic process of how I build out my plan every week. And I should say that I don't really plan for breakfast necessarily, but we always have cereal for my husband. He eats cereal every weekday. I always
have one every day.
Yeah. We can't just have two cereals. We have to have seven cereals. And then I always make hard boiled eggs for myself, on the weekend. And then I usually will have a turkey burger or a chicken burger with that for, a really easy breakfast at my desk. And then lunches, like I said, are leftovers. So I'm not really needing to plan lunches. You know, generally we'll have a few things on hand for weekend lunches, but a lot of times we'll do what I call a snack plate for the kids.
Snack where it's tray, just like I got that from you.
String cheese, lunch meat, some crackers, some olives and fruit. And they love the snack plate thing, so I don't really have to plan lunches very much.
And you could do them in little muffin tins too. I know that some kids, especially Violet's age, kind of think that's fun. It's nothing different, but you just put your little treats, or I guess they're not even treats. They might think they're treats because they're in a muffin tin, but they're food in the muffin tin, and then they eat it. Or dips. They can have different variety of dips to you know, put their stuff in. But in my house, I always tell Sully, and even way back when he was little, just exploring food, but my rule is that food should be fun. I don't care if he cooks with me or when we're eating dinner. Like, he can get as messy as he wants. It's just, I think the more times at a dinner table you might say no, or, you know, like, you can't, you know, don't be messy, or pick that up, or don't throw it on the floor. I mean, yes, of course, throwing your plate on the floor is not something we do, but it's just the more times you say no, the more aversions I think kids can get to dinner. And it seems like it's just not a fun time. So I just try and make it as fun as I can. I mean, gosh, we all have our days where we're on edge, but I do just try and, you know, say that food is fun and we can play with our food, but we have to eat our food too. But anyways, yeah, so my process is similar, but just a little different than Melissa's, where we go, we plan Monday to Monday. Sometimes we'll just go shopping on Sunday so my husband, we can just go as a family, but other times it's me going on Mondays because I have that time built in with our nanny and I can just go without Sully. Now that he's a little older, he actually enjoys going with me, so I might save that for the afternoon on Mondays. But my husband came up with a process. He's very organized, just to eliminate those stressful nights of like, oh shit, we forgot one item. Now our whole night's screwed. Let's order a pizza. Where we just write down on like a big notepad, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, all the days down Monday to Monday. And then underneath each day, we have breakfast, lunch, and dinner, because we're one of us, like I was saying last week, we're always home. So unlike Melissa's kids, and Melissa and Marty, one of us is home at all times at every meal, because Sully has a nanny coming into the house, and then George and I are both self-employed, so we can come in and out for lunch, or, you know, George packs his lunch for his office. But every single meal of every single day has something written next to it. So, you know, for us, I mean, usually I alternate breakfast. So we pick, you know, two things. It's always eggs and then something else. So like whole grain waffles or eggs and then something else. And then our lunches, we at least two days a week, we usually just do snack trays for Sully. And then George and I just kind of fend for ourselves, whether that's going out to eat once or just bringing a sandwich from home. And then our dinners, we plan. So Sundays I make a bigger meal because I'm home, and then we've got our leftovers ready for the week. But we usually plan every dinner to have leftovers for lunch the next day. So I think about that. I might make a little bit more because that just saves money. It saves time. And then if we really loved it, we didn't have leftovers. Well, we've always got, I always have something on hand, whether it's like lunch meat or, you know, hard boiled eggs. I usually boil those on Sundays. So we make, and then I always pick a snack. So we each get a snack. We've talked about that. George, Sully and I pick one for the week. So we write that in our meal plan, and then beverages as well. I know that sounds crazy, but hey, if you go to the grocery store and you see this, you know, sparkling water that looks good and that juice, and it just, it can just go overboard and it can throw your budget. So we really plan very strictly, you know, every week, and it's helped. And then so our snacks, and then I always try and make like one fun snack on Monday evenings for the week. Like we made energy bites this week. Last week we made some muffins. And so we just kind of have those to snack on throughout the week. And it's just a fun way to add new things into the menu. So yeah, ours is a bit different where we have to think of every single meal for every single day. But I tell you what, just looking at that menu every night, knowing what to take out of the freezer, it eliminates so much stress, and we've saved so much money. And I don't know if, should we talk about that now, like 4 years ago where George and I were at? So sure. 4 years ago, I'll just be super candid here. George and I both worked not for ourselves. We worked for other companies. So, and we were together, we were married, but we didn't have any kids at that time. And we kind of were like, whoa, like we make a lot of money. So, but where is our money going every month? Like, I just didn't get it. We, you know, barely had any in savings. And I felt like all we were doing was paying off student loans and having fun with our friends because we were in our mid-20s and that's what we did. But we knew it was time to kind of like check ourselves. We wanted to make some big changes. We both wanted to be self-employed within the next 2 years. And so we wanted to pay off debt. So we looked at what we were spending on, you know, groceries and entertainment and all of our other categories. And we spent on average $900 to $1,000 a month on food. Honestly, like it was entertainment in the fact where if we went to like a comedy show with our friends or our family, we'd meet up and go to a movie, whatever it might be. But the majority of it was just going out to restaurants. Like it wasn't necessarily McDonald's, you know, so we were spending money on good food, but George and I are very much, especially my husband, we're givers. So when we go out, it's like, oh, we got this, like, you know, it's your birthday. Why we're just, and so it just added up. It was every month. It was almost $1,000 plus grocery money of like, you know, $300 probably. So with that, we were like, this is crazy. We're spending our future on food that we don't have anything to show for. So we really changed our ways. And then now we spend, you know, $450 or $400 a month on groceries. And then we only allow ourselves $200 each a month for entertainment. So for fun, whatever we want to do with that money, it's ours to do. And then that has got us, you know, nearly debt free and able to leave our companies and start our own businesses. So that's just goes to show what planning and being strict with money and your menu can really do for you. And I know that not everybody is in that same boat, but like I said, I think everybody can afford to maybe pay off a student loan faster or pay your car down or, you know, pay cash for your next big purchase instead of putting it on a credit card. So, that's why we are so strict. And it's, like I said, it's just really worked for us and a lot less stressful in our home because of it. So yeah, that's kind of where we're at with our just, I guess, long story short. long story long, why we are where we are and how we do what we do. So.
Yeah. Well, I think it just goes to show that a little bit of work up front and every week has really helped you guys get to where you want to be in life. So
right.
It's not a sexy topic. It's not really that fun. I know you guys were really strict for a while you were
going through this, but now it's paid off and you're
getting. And we're used to it. And so we haven't really changed our ways, you know, so this is just the way we do it because it's paid off. And so, yeah, it was tough when our friends were out doing what they used to do all the time. And we were like, we can't go, or we're just paying for our own meal tonight and we're not treating you for your birthday and stuff like that. That was hard for us, but it has paid off for sure.
Yeah. So weekly prep. So, we've kind of covered this a few times and talked about a little bit of how we really try to do things once a week and don't make multiple trips to the grocery store and everything. So I'm going to go through a little bit more detail about why these things will help you in the long run. And then some things that you can prep ahead on the weekends to make your weeks a little bit easier.
Yeah.
Because personally, I'm not like one of those like freezer meal type of people.
It's so funny that you say this. I just have to interrupt because tonight my client asked me, oh, so you guys like make your meals on Sundays for the whole week? I'm like, hell no. I don't batch cook. Some people do, which is great, but that's just not what we do. I mean, if anything, like you say, we make a meal to have leftovers the next day, but we aren't freezing. We're not batch cooking. And we try and find meals that are doable at the end of the day. And we're going to talk about where we find our inspiration as well. But yeah, I think it's funny. That's not what really this is about and how we prep ours.
Yeah. But if that works for you, that's a great strategy. If you can find some healthy meals that you can throw in a Ziploc bag and freeze it and then pull it out when you need it. That's great. Awesome. If that works for you. That's just not my preference. Mm-hmm. I like cooking the meals on the day of, and a lot of the recipes are not the healthiest. They'll have like the cream of mushroom soups and some other ingredients that I'm not really interested in eating or preparing. But there definitely are some healthy ones out there. So if that sounds like a great idea for you, to maybe you take one Sunday every month to make 20 freezer meals and that gets you through your weeks, then that's great. Because you're still going to be saving money for sure. And you'll be saving a lot of time too if you were able to use the crock pot to help get your meals on the table.
And ultimately, you just have to choose what works for you. I say that with my clients with their workouts. Like, the goal here is to get, you know, all of these things that we're talking about to work for you and your household and your family. So whatever that is, do it. I mean, like, we're no professionals over here. We're just kind of sharing what works for us.
Yeah.
Also, we should say that we're not nutritionists either.
No.
I've been meaning to say that. I'm like, shit, we're giving a lot of advice and just know we're not nutritionists. We just are giving our own personal, you know,
preferences
and but we do know, if you are ever interested in talking to a nutritionist, we do know some we can always hook you up with. So you can email us. We've got some good ones in our back pocket. So
I'm going to run through a typical scenario of what would happen if you don't meal plan, which I'm sure some of you are going to recognize this, but it's 4 o'clock and you're about to get ready to go home and you're like, oh shit, I don't have any pasta sauce. So you go to the Byerly's or Target on your way home, grab your pasta sauce, and then you're like, oh, well, blackberries are on sale, so I better pick those up.
Oh my God, I'm hungry. I need this.
Yeah, I really need a snack. And I think I should get some wine for tonight because that sounds really good. And before you know it, you've spent $50. You went to go get pasta sauce.
And it's true. I mean, it truly happens that way. I never make a run and truly get that one thing. So not only are you increasing your grocery bill, but you added, you know, a lot of food that will probably be eaten that you didn't even need. So, you know, like the wine, you maybe wouldn't have had wine that night, but you got it. So you're going to drink it. Or if you got a bag of chips at the checkout to eat on the way home, that's something you wouldn't have got, you know, even thought about if you just had it prepped, thought about it, and it's already in the crock pot waiting for you when you got home.
Yeah. And not only the money that you're spending, but the time too, because now you've just spent 30 extra minutes getting to the store, grabbing your stuff, getting to the car and getting home. And if you, for me personally, like, I have two kids, I have to pick up at daycare by 5 o'clock. There's no way in hell I'm bringing two kids to Target to grab one thing, getting them out of their car seats, getting them in the big cart,
pushing that monster around. I hate those freaking big carts at Target. Like, there's just no way that's going to happen for me. So
it would have either been order food.
Yes.
Or you just have it on hand.
Yeah. And because we plan, every night we know what we're having for dinner, which means in the morning I take out whatever meat needs to be thawed. So, you know, take out the pork chops, take out the chicken breast, take out the hamburger. We just thaw it in our sink all day. So we don't, you know, we just let it naturally thaw and come to room temperature. So we just throw it in there. Don't think about it until the end of the day. You can also, if you forget, which it happens sometimes, throw it in like warm water or hot water to thaw it much quicker. You can thaw things in like a half an hour in that way. So that's one way planning it works great for us is every morning we know what we need to take out to have dinner, you know, ready to be made when we get home from work. The other thing is that if I am going to be gone a night, generally I do the meal planning. I pick the meals for the week and my husband will give ideas if I'm struggling or I'm just like not feeling inspired that week, I'll have him give me some ideas that we haven't had in a while or that he wants me to
make. I'll ask like, what do you want for lunch this week? Like then I'll just get him his lunches and then we've got that taken care of. So
yeah,
I think it's,
But for nights where, let's say, we had a meal planned and something came up where I wasn't going to be home, and, well, my husband still knows what to make. Mm-hmm. So he can, just make it if it's a common recipe, or I can send him the recipe through a text and he can just pull it up on his phone and get it started.
I mean, just because they've got a, doesn't mean they can't cook dinner. So same with us. I mean, I work late two nights every single week. I'm not home until after 7:30. So George is on dinner duty and that does not mean you get to just order something. And he's on board with that. But it's like, just because you're the dad or the husband or the roommate or whatever, boyfriend, doesn't mean you get to not make dinner. Like just because we have boobs doesn't mean we're the ones that have to make our nice meals. So we try and set it up so it's a seamless process where on the nights I'm gone, we'll have maybe crock pot, like I'll kind of get it ready in the morning. Or if not, hey, feed our kid, feed yourself. You can see the menu. And not that they're resistant of that, but it's just kind of funny to think like they don't set us up for our, nights that we cook. But
well, yeah. And the nice thing about planning for your schedule is like, the whole family knows I'm going to be gone on Tuesday nights this month because of these webinars. So we purposely planned an easy meal for those nights because wrangling two kids and trying to make dinner just isn't really going to happen if it's something complicated. So, tonight they had a pizza from Aldi, super easy. Another, sometimes they'll pick up gyros or they'll just pick, we'll just have an easy meal. Maybe it's just going to be tacos.
But it's in the plan. And I think that's a huge thing. We do that too. We look at our menu our week. What do we have going on? This Friday, okay, Molly and George are going out to dinner. Sully's having this for dinner. So it's very well organized. And we try to really focus on, if we're going to Melissa and Marty's one night, that's in our meal plan. We don't buy a meal that night or whatever it might be. So it's just, you're not buying extra food. Very rarely in either of our houses are you going to find a pantry full of like glory and treats and food or extras. Like we have our staples and our meals and that's about it. So
yeah,
Sunday it's slim pickings.
Yeah. And I actually feel bad sometimes because, we plan our meals for the week. And then maybe in the middle of the week, my dad might call and be like, hey, what are you guys doing on Saturday? Mm-hmm. We might stop up. And I'm like, well, crap, we only plan to have like pork chops, which is only enough for our family. And we don't really have enough to share, So sometimes I feel bad because we aren't super like, come on over for dinner at the last minute because we don't have all that extra food necessarily.
Dad usually brings food.
Yeah.
Oh, he'll just bring like a cooler full of meat that we need or whatever it might be. But yeah, it can be, or when you don't expect guests, to stop over for lunch and have a play date or whatever it might be, you have to kind of improvise. But yeah, that's just how we stay on track with everything. Yeah. I think we should talk about too. So like, let's talk about like we get raw vegetables on our grocery trip. So right when we get home, we usually wash, cut, prep and put them away. So they're easy snacks for the week, their lunches, whatever it might be. So you're not sitting there like peeling a carrot at 7 a.m. as you're trying to get to work by 9. Mm-hmm. So that's one quick way. Same with our fruit. We just wash it all and it's ready to go, grab mm-hmm. and go.
I actually don't really prep vegetables ahead of time. Generally, we use our vegetables for like roasting. So we usually cut them up at the time each night.
We're huge raw veggie snackers. So we always, if they're not prepped, they won't be eaten. And so we just do that right away. And then we grab them all the time and dip them in salsas or hummus or whatever it might be.
Yeah, I think that's a great idea because the veggies, if you are planning to like eat them raw, cutting them up and having them readily available is going to be the way to be successful at that. Because like you said, you're like, oh, I'm hungry for a snack. I better go individually peel my carrots.
Yeah.
And chop them up. And
yeah, it just doesn't happen. Then it's like, I'll just grab this instead or whatever it might be.
Or you can just buy the baby carrots.
I have a thing. I've got a thing about these. The full carrots taste so much different. I don't know. I like rave about them. I don't like baby carrots. They look slimy, I think, all the time.
Ours get slimy because they always end up in the back of the produce drawer and we forget about them.
I just think that, and that goes for a lot of things too. I was going to say with even our meat. So if we get, if there's ground beef on sale or something like that, and there's like a 3-pound thing of it, we cut it up right away, split it. And then we've got, our three meals already individually.
We do that with our Costco meat too, because like the chicken breasts come in like 6 packs of 2 breasts that are all like attached. So you have to like cut them up to make mm-hmm. the packs, and like the big pork loins we talked about, I think last week mm-hmm. we cut those up. So we have like 2 roasts and like 12 pork chops. And we put them in bags in the freezer. So yeah, they're all ready to go, right away.
And it sucks when you forget to do that. Cause you're like, oh, now I have to make something with ground beef for the next 3 days because I have to thaw it all out and we've got to use it. So, again, just planning ahead and being super organized is going to go a long way.
Yeah. So other than actual planning out your meals, you can do some other things to make your week less stressful and a little bit easier, as well. So like I said before, I make hard boiled eggs. So I make like 10 a week to have 2 every day that I'm at work. I pretty much make a box of chicken burgers or turkey burgers every week and just have those in the fridge to eat with my eggs. I make like peanut butter if I need peanut butter or almond butter, I make that on Sundays. So then we can just have it ready to go to scoop out for recipes. Other sauces and spices. So like we make our own taco seasoning. I've been making my own ranch while I'm on Whole30. Just doing all of that stuff on the weekend when you have the time is going to save so much hassle throughout the week and probably prevent you from grabbing a snack from the vending machine because you didn't have something on hand. I'm sure everyone has heard this, but failing to plan is planning to fail. So if you want to be successful with eating healthier, saving money, saving time, you have to plan ahead for that stuff. Mm-hmm. And, it's not the most enjoyable thing you're going to do on your weekend, but you can really set yourself up for success by spending those few hours.
Yeah, like
front.
I said before, it does become enjoyable because you do realize what you're saving and how healthy you're eating and, just making food fun. I think it goes a long way.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest, we really only make about 1 new recipe a week. Like that's my goal every week is 1 new recipe that we haven't had before.
Yeah.
So we have, it's not like we're planning these fancy meals 7 days a week. We have our old standbys. We have our super easy meals like tacos. We love zoodles and sauce with Italian sausage. We have a couple of like stir fry dishes that are always on rotation, hamburgers. It's like, these are things that everybody makes, usually, but we like to throw in at least 1 new recipe a week. And then I have like my big meals that need leftovers. Those are more of like the casseroles and, mm-hmm. The stuff that you bake in the oven in a big 9x13 pan so that you have those leftovers or like a chili or
a
soup.
A lot of crock pot stuff for us is our leftover meals, shredded, super easy stuff like, chicken breast, jar of salsa, homemade taco seasoning and you've got shredded chicken tacos ready to go. And then for the next day, even for lunch.
Yeah, you can make a chicken taco salad the next day.
It doesn't matter. And same, I mean, it just, we try and do at least one or two of those bigger meals a week as well. It doesn't take a lot of time, a lot of effort really at all. But yeah, we try and whether it's a new recipe or I kind of try and get creative, like let's try a meatless recipe on one day to mm-hmm. save money, or let's have maybe a theme throughout the week of some sort of a new vegetable or something like that. And it's, gosh, don't get me wrong, like there are weeks that I'm like, oh, this menu is kind of lame, but yeah. It is what it is. And, you know, if you ask, you know, my husband really craves hearty food. He doesn't, you know, and a lot of his go-tos could be from a box if I'd let him.
Hamburger helper.
Yeah. God, so funny. It's so old school. It's so bad, but it is so good at times. So yeah, I think it's just, you know, finding those hearty meals, filling them with protein. And then I think we're going to be talking a lot about, especially next week, but mixing food with fitness and how to build your body, or how food can help you build the body that you want, and giving out a lot of ideas on snacks, healthy snack options. I'll be sending those out through Malisa. But yeah, I had some people just ask me this week, a client, about breakfast ideas, because, you know, she's just getting a little bit bored with the usual, even hard-boiled eggs. You talk about that a lot. So there are a lot of ways it can be quick and easy, but it doesn't have to be hard-boiled eggs or fruit. I mean,
overnight oats?
Yeah, I've talked about that. Overnight oats. You can even do, I can't believe you haven't said this. A lot of her breakfasts are leftovers with an egg on top, like an actual, you know, and then she eats it in the morning and it's like this huge, it's like this beautiful meal that you would think she, you know, got at some awesome restaurant. But she does a lot of like her hash, whatever she makes the night before, and she puts an egg on top of it to make this really nice meal. So that's an option for a breakfast. You can eat at your desk. But even like grabbing, you know, a slice of turkey and string cheese, like it doesn't have to be a breakfast food all the time. And so we'll be sending out some ideas for snacks, which can obviously be correlated into like mini meals throughout your day. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah, I think if your goal is to eat healthier and save money, you have to do the leftovers because if you are tasking yourself every night with making a brand new lunch for the next day, it's going to get tiring. You're going to get too tired. You're going to want to watch your show and it doesn't get done until 10:30. And well, I guess I'll just go out tomorrow.
Yeah, right.
But having leftovers in the fridge, it's like just grab that Tupperware, throw it in your bag, throw an apple in with it. And there's your lunch. It's so much easier. It takes the thought out of lunches.
I also have to say a lot of clients, especially because, you know, their goal is weight loss, that everybody has these amazing ideas to like make these beautiful salads every day. And it's just like not realistic. When George and I didn't have Sully, we would two nights a week, we would actually do chef salads of some sort. And we would make like we'd put a different dressing on it, or we'd kind of add different things to it. But Sullivan's not going to eat a salad for dinner. So we've had to really kind of change our ways. And, you know, you can plan maybe one or two lunches of salads, but to think you're going to have a salad every day of the week for a lunch or a dinner, it's kind of setting yourself up for some failure. I have to be honest. It takes a lot of prep to build a salad. So you can do, you know, you could do lettuce wrap, you know, with the turkey or with ham and make, you know, you're getting your greens in that way, or making a smoothie. So it's a little bit faster. You're not having to like prep your meals quite as much, and then designate one night a week to have this big, beautiful salad or one lunch. But it is kind of setting yourself up for failure if you think you're going to do that every day. Cause like she said, it's just a lot of prep. And by 10 o'clock, you're like, I'm over it. Like I'm not going to sit and like, you know, cut up all these veggies and cut my lettuce or whatever.
So. Or if you really do want to have salads every day, then do it on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Make your five bowls and load them
in a mason jar.
Or mason jar. Yeah.
And good way to keep them fresh.
You know, keep the stuff, obviously you wouldn't dress them at that point, but put all of the ingredients in a bowl and prep five salads on Sunday. Take an hour to do that. And then you could
have
your
salad. Yeah, that's a little more doable. But anyway, that was just something I think, you know, there are other ways to get healthy meals other than, you know, just a salad every day. So I think some people are on that train of thought. Same with like our media posts today of lean cuisines and just how easy they are. But gosh, if you look on the back of those.
I'm a lean cuisine convert. I used to eat a lean cuisine for lunch probably 3 days a week.
Mm-hmm. And a Diet Coke.
And a Diet Coke, yes, of course. Mm-hmm. And like 100 calorie pack.
Yeah.
Like that was my lunch after college at work.
Yep.
Probably until like 4 years ago. Or I would eat Hot Pockets and a Diet Coke and 100 calorie pack.
And I just bet that rings a bell to a lot of you. I mean, it might not even be every day that you're doing it, but more than you realize, you're eating convenience meals. So healthy meals can be convenient too, if you just think about it. Like even our turkey patties that we, you know, buy the box of, like you bake all of them, or, you know, five of them at once, and there's your lunch for the week. You know, that's super easy. You can add avocados to it and salsa, and you're done. So it doesn't, convenient food doesn't have to be bad food, as long as you're planning ahead and just kind of thinking outside the box a little bit.
Yeah. And the reason we're like dissing lean cuisine is goes back to our first webinar about why eating real food. There's just so many chemicals and preservatives in those that, you know, make it freezable and then still taste decent once you heat it up. Sodium is really high in those freezer meals. And obviously, you all know what's wrong with Diet Coke, but, you know, it still lives on in my heart. So I'm not going to bash anyone for drinking their Diet Coke occasionally.
Cheers. And again, it's we're all human. We all eat and have our little weaknesses. But once in a while, like I always say, a bad day of eating is not going to ruin a full week of hard working out or hard workout. So, you know, a bad meal is not going to cancel out all your good meals that you've had throughout the week or your thought you've put into them. But it's just when you get in that habit of eating these low calorie, low fat, easy, convenient meals, like not only will your, you know, grocery bill go up, but also your, a lot of people see their weight going up with the sodium in it. And that makes you crave other things. So it's just fresh is best. And
and you could be eating so much more food than a lean cuisine.
What?
For the same number of calories, probably, yeah. Or even a little bit more, but they're better calories.
Yeah, because they're coming from real food. So
yeah. We don't really count calories, so don't talk to us about that.
We really don't. So I think let's talk about where we find some inspiration.
Yes.
And then I'll probably be it.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's.
Okay. So for me, I find most of my meals on Pinterest. I still really like using that as like a menu filler. Generally, I'll be able to think of like at least 4 or 5 recipes every week without looking at Pinterest. But then it's like, well, I'm ready. I need to find that new recipe that I want to try. So, you know, I'll either just search like my home feed and see what comes up, or if I have like a certain meat in mind that I need to use, you know, I'll search by that, or I'll look for like, if I need a bigger meal that I want to try, I'll search for a casserole. So Pinterest is really great for finding meal ideas. You know, it can kind of be a little overwhelming sometimes, but if you have a little bit of an idea of what you're looking for, I think it's still like the best place to find new recipes, mm-hmm. And the most convenient.
Yeah.
And of course, you can always go to my boards if you're interested. M Leaser Planning is my name. And I have a board for like fast and easy recipes. I have some crock pot recipes. I have some instant pot recipes, which is like my new favorite toy. Mm-hmm. So check that out. And then I also really love this blog called inspiralized.com. So it's all recipes that include some element that is spiralized. And if you don't know what a spiralizer is, it's a tool that basically makes like zucchini or potatoes
noodles.
Or anything into a noodle, mm-hmm. essentially. So we always use it for zucchini noodles with pasta sauce. But she has some super creative recipes using all sorts of different fruits and vegetables and as a replacement to noodles. So check that out if you're interested. She does have an app, and I think it's $1.99, but I actually downloaded it because you can favorite recipes so that you can go back and access them really easily.
Well, and you usually do a weekly roundup of what you make throughout your week. So
yes.
I, either text her or I look there for ideas. So she's always posting, whether it's on Instagram or usually your blog, what you made for the week. So that's always a great place to start as well.
Yeah, every Friday I post our weekly menu on melissaleaserplanning.com.
I do Pinterest as well. I use my sister. I use my girlfriends at Meal Plan. But one of my favorite websites is called skinnytaste.com. And the name might be a little deceiving, but the whole idea behind this person's website is that they break it down by, if you're doing, you know, you could be under, like you could be doing calories. So if you want under X amount of calories, you could do it by points. If you're on Weight Watchers, so you can search this many point meals and that many point meals, which I've said before, I'm a huge fan of Weight Watchers because you can eat any foods you'd like to eat. And they're in their program, I believe fruits and veggies are free. And I always tell my clients that as well, like you don't worry about fruits and veggies. You just fill up on them and they are of zero cost, or you just shouldn't even worry about it. But anyways, and you can also go on her website and on the sidebar, it's beef recipes, chicken. And then she breaks it down into like Mexican, Asian, Italian. So she just, I love how organized it is. If like she said, oh, hey, I have Italian sausage on hand. What could I use for this, or a casserole, or whatever it might be? Maybe I'm having my brother-in-law over that is gluten-free. You can go into the gluten-free tab and see what she has. So I love that. And then she's also very mindful. It's very, you know, the majority of her foods are whole foods recipes, not all, but most, and lower in, you know, fat and calories and all of that. So she's really put a lot of thought into it. So that's skinnytaste.com. That's my favorite go-to, I would say.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I actually just had a friend tell me about one yesterday who was doing Weight Watchers, and I think it was Drizzle Me Skinny, maybe.
Sure.
I'll look it up and put it in the email.
Give me some of that.
But she said that there are a lot of Weight Watchers recipes on there too, if you're on that program. The other one I really love is an Instagram account called Whole30 Recipes. You don't have to be doing the Whole30 to eat these, obviously, but there's just some really creative recipes out there that are using real whole foods that would be sugar-free, dairy-free, grain-free, soy-free.
And when you're not on Whole30, you think, well, what the hell are you eating then? But it is fun to see, like, this is what you can eat even without all of these things.
Yeah, it's so actually really amazing, like, the meals that people come up with on such a strict short-term diet, but I have really found a lot of inspiration there. And that's where I learned about like the Whole30 Ranch and some other products that are Whole30 approved that I never even heard of, but turned out to be really good, even if you're not on Whole30. And then lastly, there's an app, the All Recipes app, which is pretty good. They have this thing called a dinner spinner. So if you have, let's say you have some ingredients, you're not really sure what to make with them, you can plug those in and do the spinner and it will come up with some recipe ideas for you.
That's so cool.
So that's just kind of a cool one if you are in a pinch or you're trying to use up some of your pantry items and you're not really sure what to do with them. That's something to check out too.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So those are my favorite resources for finding recipes. I don't really use like books or anything printed these days.
It's so bad. But hey, convenience is key. And that's what the internet and all these apps are for. So
yeah,
use them.
So I think that wraps up our discussion. We didn't go into a ton of detail, but like I said, I will have that free email course coming up. And it's going to be a 5-day course of like start to finish how to meal plan from starting in your kitchen to, you know, looking in your fridge to getting to the store and grabbing all your food. So I'm really excited about it. I think it'll be helpful for people who are just beginning. And in our email, we are going to include sort of a guide for meal planning that I put together. It was based on one of my blog posts that I did a while back. So hopefully you find that useful as well. And we can't forget about our giveaway for tonight. And I'm really excited because as I've mentioned a few times, I'm trying to sort of launch a business around teaching people how to meal plan, how to budget, how to just kind of take the stress out of meal planning and meal prep. So I'm going to give away an hour session with, so it's just going to be like a Skype call with me. We can talk about any challenges that you're facing with your meal planning or cleaning up your diet or, you know, specific challenges to your life, and we can walk through some solutions. So I'm really excited to kind of use you as a guinea pig.
So hopefully you listen to all 50 minutes of this.
Yes.
So you know to email and say, yes, I want in.
So to enter.
Give me some of that.
Yes. So to enter, you have to reply to the email we send out with the video, and we will pick a winner by the end of the week. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I'm really excited.
That's really cool.
To try it out.
Yeah, and then next week we're going to be talking about food and fitness. So digging in a little bit more on the fitness side of things. I know we've talked about how to get to this point and with food, but I think now it's time to talk about incorporating fitness into eating healthy and whole foods.
And I need this.
And so I needed all of that. And then now it's time for me to talk a little bit about how to wrap that all together. And and just how your body is going to benefit and how your workouts can benefit for all of this prep that we've been talking about. So we hope you join via email again next week. And then, we'd love to see you on our social media. Say hi, comment on a picture,
yes,
and we will see you all next week. Have a healthy one.
Bye. Bye.